Mr. Clark.
Sir?
Anything?
Well, I've been looking through the footage of the security cameras at Esoteria blasting and explosives, and two people can be seen walking through the halls at approximately 10 after 2 in the afternoon on the 24th of August. The same day the cop killer was taken down.
Show me. That's him. That's Bernard, I know it.
You may be right, but both men are facing away from the camera. This footage won't hold up in court.
I know that. See what else you can find. If we can pull it off, I want Bernard legally taken down. Come on, where are you?
God, this is so frustrating!
Tell me about it. I've been looking through this footage for nearly 2 hours straight now, and I still haven't found our killer. What time was it when we got to the Gentleman's Club? Can you remember?
Huh? I don't know.
What footage are you looking through? Camera 4?
Oh, what are you doing?
Hey, you should be grateful you're not in my position. One minute you're running and gunning trying to do a speed run, and the next minute you have to play a stupid Ashley Graham and run into one of these goddamn sliding block puzzles. The developer's wet dream and the gamer's nightmare.
You're supposed to be helping me look through the Gentleman's Club security camera footage and find whoever murdered our lead.
Well, what's the big deal? There's only one camera that faces the entrance to the club's bathroom that we might get a glimpse of the killer from, and you're already looking at the footage from it, so, you know?
Yeah, I'm sorry. This is just getting really tedious, and I figured you might have found something to do that was slightly more productive.
Fuck!
Just search for a video walkthrough on YouTube or something.
I can't. There's no internet on this thing.
What?
Ever since Howard had Vista installed on all the lab computers, I haven't been able to figure out how to get into network connections.
Oh, well, log on to another terminal that has internet, then.
I can't, dude. I told you I'm speedrunning this, and I haven't saved it any typewriters. I can't quit or restart. God, I was doing so well, and now I'm failing miserably at this stupid puzzle. Every second I spend on it is going to increase my eventual completion time and further submerging my mind in a bottomless chasm of homicidal rage.
Wait, dude, I think I found... Oh, never mind, that's not him.
Okay, seriously, God, please grant me the power to solve this puzzle, and I'll never ask anything of you again. Okay? Go. God damn it, this sucks! Oh no. No. No, 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 no. No!
Normally I'd rip on you for overreacting and destroying equipment, but I don't care. Staring at this footage has fried my brain. I can't fast forward it either, because then the footage starts skipping and I could miss the killer entering and exiting the bathroom entirely. Oh, I can't even blink. This sucks. My eyes are, like, so dried out. Wait. Wait, there's our lead. There's our lead entering the bathroom now. And then... our killer, following him in. He's facing away from the camera, though. Gotta wait for him to come back out. There. He's the guy that must have drowned our lead in the bathroom sink. Wait. That's the same guy that tried to poison us back at the chemical facility.
Are you sure?
We're on to something now, dude. If my suspicions are correct, one way or another, this guy is going to somehow lead us to Roman's involvement in all this.
The governor?
You cannot tell Howard or Max about this. Not yet, anyway.
Oh, hey, guys. I was looking for you.
Hey, Max.
Hey.
So what do you guys have on the agenda tonight?
Nothing really. In fact, we were just gonna head home, chill, and go straight to bed in a few hours. We got a, major lead on a case, and, we need our energy for tomorrow.
Oh, that's lame, cause I was gonna say, the two of you should come out with me tonight, hit up the clubs, you know.
Clubbing?
I don't know, Max. That's not really my thing, and Eddie and I should probably-
Oh, come on, guys. We need to bond a bit more. We've never gone out for beers after work or anything. Don't be pussies. It'll be fun.
Well, I suppose I could use a bit of a distraction from work.
Sweet. Alright, well, why don't you guys drop by my house a little later this evening, and we'll hit up the clubs together from there, okay? Peace!
Later.
We're done for the day, Howard. Have a good one.
Oh, yeah, you too, Bernard. So you guys are all going out clubbing tonight?
Oh, yeah. You wanna come?
Sure. I guess I'll meet you guys at Max's later tonight, then.
Okay.
It'll be like a boys' night out, eh? No girls allowed.
Whatever.
Oh, Howard, one of the lab computers is busted.
What? How?
No idea. So, I guess I'll meet you at Max's place in a few hours, then?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay, later.
Mr. Brown. Governor,
always a pleasure seeing you around. Though with a consistently shit-eating grin like yours, one would expect you to be so full of shit that you should be constantly on the toilet. In all likelihood, wiping your ass with everyone's tax dollars.
Ah, how I do enjoy your signature wit, Bernard. I know it was you who brought down the cop killer.
Admirable.
And illegal.
That's quite the accusation. Too bad you don't have any proof.
Yet. But when I do, you'll have plenty of free time to conjure up more of those witty remarks of yours in prison. For as long as my power will allow. Good day. I am the master of squats. I could probably crush steel with my godly thighs. Whoa, Bernard and Ed are pretty early. Oh, Mr. Drake.
Good evening, Max. I hope I'm not interrupting.
Oh, not at all. I was just, working out. What can I do for you, Governor?
I was hoping you'd be able to shed some light on a particular issue for me, specifically the murder of a man I understand you interacted with a few weeks ago.
Oh, yeah. Unfortunately, there's not much I can tell you. All I know is what's stated in the report already. The body was found by police at Esoteria Blasting and Explosives and was most likely another one of the cop killer's victims.
I see. Any idea who notified police of the situation?
According to the report, it was an anonymous tip that gunshots were heard in the area.
Anonymous. I see. I understand a few days before the murder, you spent a considerable amount of time with the man after he caused a scene at the shopping center. Did you happen to get his name?
Yeah, he did. He told me his name was...
Strange name. Thank you, Max. That will be all.
Anytime, Governor.
I understand you and your team are heading out later this evening for a night on the town.
Yeah, that's right.
That's great. You guys have a good time. Give Bernard my best.
Tonight's gonna suck.
Hey, what's up, dogs?
Not much, dog.
You guys ready to hit up the clubs?
Hey! What's going down, homies?
Oh yeah,
I invited Howard.
Oh, man.
What's the big deal?
Because he'll cramp our styles, dude. You know how some guys are chick magnets? Howard's the opposite. He's the anti-pussy, Bernard.
The anti-pussy?
Hey, Howard. Guys? So we all ready to get our freak on tonight? Yes, Howard. Hey, guys, I'm just gonna go around the back and get my car. Oh, no. You can just ride with me. I got room. God damn it. Thanks, Howard. Man, this is gonna rock to the max.
This sucks! You haven't said a word all night. You alright?
Yeah, sorry. I'm just tired.
So you're like a cop?
That's right, sweetheart. Got my own gun and everything.
Oh my god, that's like so cool.
So, what do you say we head back to my place a little later tonight?
Hey, no, Max, I don't have room in my car for another person. Remember, the back is filled with my grandma's laundry.
Who are you? Are you guys like brothers?
No, I'm his boss. I gave him a ride here.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, he's a terrific employee. Aren't you, Max? Huh?
Aw, you guys are cute. I gotta go now, though. See ya. Nice meeting you.
You too, ma'am. Hey, excuse me, miss. How would you like to get jiggy with it? Fuck!
What happened? I thought you were doing pretty well over there with that girl.
I was, until I was tainted by the fucking anti-pussy over there. I told you he was a buzzkill.
Can you dance?
I only know how to square dance. But I must warn you, my moves are sublime.
Sorry, I think my boyfriend's calling me.
Thanks a lot, Bernard, by the way.
What? I'm not gonna just tell Howard he can't come with us. What was I supposed to tell him? Besides, clubs aren't places to be meeting women anyway.
Oh, let me guess. You're waiting for the perfect woman to come along suddenly while you're in the library, or standing in a lineup at a grocery store, or when you're carrying all your lame romance novels and she bumps into you and adorably kneels down to help you pick them all up. And your hands touch as you both reach for the same book, right? Guess what? Doesn't happen. Your attitude is forever gonna doom you to a sex-free existence, Bernard. Mark my words.
I'm gonna go to the bathroom, guys.
I think something's wrong with Eddie. I'm not sure what, though.
Just leave him be, man. He'll be all right.
You know what's bothering him?
I don't want to get into it.
Well, it's just that you went to the bathroom and then you didn't come back and we were worried about you. Where are you now?
At home.
You just came out of the bathroom and went straight home? How come you never told us where you were going?
I just wasn't in the mood to talk to anybody or be at that nightclub anymore. Sorry, I didn't mean to worry you guys. I'll see you at work tomorrow, okay?
All right, see ya.
Excuse me, who are you?
What? I was here first. Who are you?
I'm sorry. It's just that anyone being here besides me seems kind of peculiar. I wasn't aware that my brother had any friends.
Well, this is lame. We can't find any dirt on this guy.
No. It's like he doesn't even exist. Not in the system, at least.
So all we've got to go on is a few hundred pixels of his helmet from this blurry-ass photo.
Yeah.
What should we do?
The only thing we can do for the time being. There's a chance he could be a regular at the Esoteria Gentlemen's Club. We should stake out the place and see if he comes back.
Oh, stake out? Cool!
It's not that cool. The guy was at the club at around 10 in the morning last time, so we should get into position now. I'm just gonna go take a leak real quick and then we'll take off, okay? Be right back. Remember, not a word to Howard or Max.
Okay.
Good morning, Edward.
Good morning, Governor.
So, what are you and your team working on today?
Oh, you know, just the usual stuff. A couple reports of vandalism, you know, graffiti, broken windows, that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. You sure about that?
Yeah. Sorry, Governor, but I gotta get going. I'm pretty sure Bernard's waiting for me in the parking lot, so, yeah.
Oh, I'd better not keep you then.
Man, this is so cool. It's like we're undercover cops.
We are undercover cops.
Oh, yeah. Hey, did you see Max at the department this morning?
No. Why?
Oh, nothing. I just hope he got home okay from the club last night. He was probably just running late. Not to mention hungover.
The hell? This isn't my apartment. There's no porn anywhere. Where am I?
Morning, sleepyhead! I've got a surprise for you. I made waffles!
Who are you?
Yeah, very funny, mister. Come on, before your waffles get cold, eh?
God damn it! How do I keep getting myself into these situations?
Oh, what's this? There's a big glass of chocolate milk in here with someone's name on it. Whose name is it, eh? Let's see here. Oh, it's yours, Max. It's yours. Get your ass in here.
God, this is so boring. I bet the guy isn't even gonna show up either.
Aren't you gonna answer that?
No, I know who it is. You know the weird guy that was killed at the explosives place, right?
Yeah?
Yeah, well, I was at his grave last night and I ran into his brother.
Seriously?
Yeah, and since then he's been so clingy, I could barely shake him off last night. And I woke up this morning and had like 100 voicemails. This is one of them, okay? Listen.
Hey, B-Man, me again. Listen, I just got out of the bath, and I was just getting ready for bed, and I found my old Pog collection in one of my old Batman socks. I was just wondering if you wanted to come over and play Pogs for a bit. I know it's kind of late, but, you know, I taped some reruns of Everybody Loves Raymond. I thought if you came over, we could, you know, just break out a couple of the Capri Suns and make a night of it, you know? Maybe grab some breakfast at Denny's in the morning. Anyway, if you can, like if you can, you can probably hear this right now, like, you're probably in bed, and you're probably, like, trying to ignore this, but, you know, if you could just get out of bed and, like, answer me, and, like, or just call me back, you know, that would be great, because it's almost 4 a.m, and I always play with my cat at that time, like, I always play with my cat at 4 a.m, because, and I gotta unplug my phone cord and run around the house with it, because the cat likes to chase it. And if I don't do it, like, at 4 a.m. precisely, it might cough up a hairball in my cornflakes again. So, yeah, if you could just call me back, ASAP, that would be excellent. Excellent-a-roonio. Talk to you later, man.
What the fuck? Seriously. We only met last night. At his brother's grave. Clinginess must be genetic in that family.
Does he know?
That I'm the one who got his brother killed? No, not yet.
It wasn't your fault, dude.
I don't know how to tell him, you know?
Hey, what's the matter, man? Why, you've barely touched your waffles!
Where am I?
Oh, Max, you are such a jokester.
No. Seriously. I'm serious.
You're serious?
No. I'm I'm so serious right now. Oh, no, don't cry. Jesus. Come on.
It's just, I thought we were going to be great friends. And I slaved away making carrot cake this morning for the two of us. And
look, I'm sorry, but I'm a cop. I work with a division of the EPD, erect. And I gotta get to work or my boss is gonna put his foot inside my butt.
I don't think you are where you think you are. It could take you a little while to get to work.
What do you mean?
This is Canada.
Canada? Canada? That's like a billion miles away! What the fuck am I doing in Canada?
You don't remember? We met in Club Seduction in the States. We hit it off. At least I thought we did. We took a bus together to Canada and rode to my apartment on Mooseback.
Oh my God!
You really don't remember anything from last night?
No!
Get out.
What?
Get the hell out of my apartment! And no more waffles for you!
But I've got no car or money to get home, dude!
Yeah, well, you should have thought of that before you played games with my heart, Max!
God damn it, can I at least have some cake?
Get the fuck away from my door before I call the police!
Alright! God. But I am the police.
Right here is fine.
You sure? I don't mind dropping you off right up at your house.
Nah, thanks. I'll enjoy the walk. I could use a little stretch of the legs anyway. Sitting in this seat for the past 14 hours has made my butt cheeks atrophy. Same thing tomorrow?
Yeah. I know. But we have to.
Yeah. Alright, peace.
Later, man.
Hey, you've reached Eddie Stryker's voicemail. Sorry I'm not available to take your call, but to make up for it, I will now recite the facility theme from GoldenEye.
Barrel, barrel. Barrel, now, now.
Shit.
Barrel,
answer your
barrel.
Phone, Eddie.
Barrel, barrel, now.
Hey!
Oh, Jesus Christ, dude. Where did you come from? How'd you even know I was here?
Oh, I was just in the neighborhood and I saw you over here.
God, I'm supposed to be undercover right now. At least get in the car before you blow it for me.
Cool. Nice car. Oh, it's got a CD player. Yo, you got any songs by Soldier Boy?
Keep your voice down. And no, I don't.
Dude, are you hungry? I'm like fucking starving. I'm gonna go to the corner store across the street, okay?
By all means. Jesus Christ.
Hey! Hey,
Please shut up.
No!
Damn! What?
Want anything?
No!
I'm getting a drumstick. You know that, like, ice cream shit? Want a drumstick? Bernard! Bernard! Want a drumstick?
No!
Yes, you do. Sir, I'm a police officer and I need to commandeer this vehicle. Please exit the vehicle, sir.
Certainly, eh? May I see your badge?
Yeah. Hold on. Shit. My badge is gone. Can I at least hitch a ride with you then?
No, suck my balls.
Man, that drumstick was killer.
Yeah?
Yeah. I love him. Of course, not as much as my brother did. He was crazy for him, you know?
Look, man. I gotta tell you something. Something you're probably not gonna like.
What? Can't be that bad, B-Man.
Your brother. When he was killed, he was with me.
What?
I was hunting down the cop killer that was all over the news 3 weeks ago, and he had taken down all my team members. Your brother was temporarily recruited as an officer to assist me in the investigation. I managed to find the killer's location, and he came with me to where he was hiding out. He got the better of me and held your brother at gunpoint. He was shot because of my hesitation to take any action.
Once he was shot, I took the killer out before he shot me next. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, you're certainly gonna be, Mr. Brown. Hey, Howard. What's the deal with all those cars in the parking lot? Is there some kind of intervention going on?
That would be a very appropriate way of putting it, Bernard.
What the hell is this?
You are under arrest for disobeying a direct order from the government by secretly continuing a banned investigation, along with the murder of 2 citizens as a result of gross negligence.
Again with this? You have no proof!
Once he was shot, I took the killer out before he shot me next.
so sorry.
No. No, no, hold on a minute. I put an end to potentially numerous deaths of officers. And I only took the killer down in self-defense. The second death was by his hand.
Your intentions behind your actions are irrelevant. You've committed a criminal offense by disobeying direct orders issued from a government level and are thus a danger to the city of Esoteria, as well as this department and those around you.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of law.
Mother of God, I'm so hungry. Where the fuck are all the restaurants? Where's Canada's famous Canadian bacon? Where's anything? All there is snow. Just fucking snow. What was that? Hello? Who's there? What the hell? Is that a horse? With antlers? Okay, I must be hallucinating from hunger or some shit.
No.
Holy shit! God damn it, the trigger's frozen! I fucking hate Canada!
No.
Ah! Hey! Hey, stranger! Up here, eh? Up here!
Oh man, I feel like I've just been falcon punched. What the hell? It's the 20th? I've been asleep for 2 days! Oh man, I am so fired! So what's your story, eh?
I'm a cop from the States. I got stupid drunk the other night. Woke up in some guy's apartment a few dozen miles from here, and he kicked me out. You know, the two of you sound remarkably similar, not to mention your armor is identical.
Hey, we don't all look and sound alike. That's offensive, eh?
Sorry. My name's Max, by the way. Max Dangerfield.
Dudley Punter, professional moose hunter, at your service. Pleased to meet you.
Professional what hunter?
Moose. You must be familiar with moose.
What are they, like some kind of mutant horse? Is that what nearly killed me back there?
Indeed. You gotta be real careful around these parts, eh?
What's that noise?
Quiet! Get down!
Is that another moose?
No. Canucks fan. Very dangerous this time of year.
I'm really sorry I'm late, Howard. For some reason, I slept for 2 days straight. And I'll make it up to you whatever way I can.
It's okay, Eddie.
What's with all the commotion outside? There's cops lined up, the press.
Eddie, Bernard's been arrested.
What?
Evidence was presented by Governor Drake this morning placing Bernard at Esoteria Blasting and Explosives. The day the cop killer and that innocent civilian were taken down, proving his involvement in a strictly off-limits investigation.
You defended Bernard, though, right? He doesn't deserve to go to jail!
Eddie, my hands are tied. The best I could do was request that he be held in detention on the lower floor until you arrived, so you could personally escort him to the Esoteria Maximum Security Prison. Even that was pushing it.
How does that help Bernard?
I figured he could at least use a friend like you at his side before he's in prison for what could be 5 years. And that's assuming Roman doesn't pull any strings to extend his sentence. And he probably will.
Howard,
Do you have any idea what you're asking me to do?
I'm not gonna get away with this.
I beg to differ.
Governor Drake! Governor Drake, may we ask you a few questions?
Certainly.
May we ask what Officer Brown said to you just then when he approached you?
Oh, he just offered a feeble apology in an attempt to worm out of a well-deserved prison sentence.
How do you respond to those citizens of Esoteria that are angered with you for employing an agent of corruption such as Officer Brown within the police department? Its very purpose being to uphold the law.
While I personally did not approve Mr. Brown's employment, I do take full responsibility for his actions, and will do everything in my power to make sure something like this will never happen again. You can take my word for it.
So you're my prison escort, huh?
I hate this just as much as you do, Bernard.
I think that's arguable.
Waiting for. The rain cleared up at least. The sun shining, nice breeze. What a fabulous day to go to prison. Although, speaking of which, this doesn't look like the route to Esoteria Prison.
That's because we're not going to Esoteria Prison.
What?
You're an idiot if you think I'm just gonna drive you straight to jail and watch you sit in a cell for half a decade, Bernard.
Hold on, wait a minute. What the hell is going on then? Where are we going?
We're making a run for the Canadian border.
Are you insane? You're pissing your career away. You realize you might as well have just taken a shit on Roman's desk. You'd still have been fired, but hopefully without any jail time.
Either my career goes down the toilet or my principles do, and the latter is out of the question. I'm not gonna see you get locked up. You're my friend.
If we get caught, we are both fucked. I'm gonna get my sentence doubled. And you're destroying your goddamn life!
Hey, don't you even think about lecturing me! Jesus Christ, I thought you were gonna be happy! And don't remind me that I'm fucked in case I change my mind. I don't really want to think about it right now. It hasn't sunk in yet. If I let it, I'd probably go insane.
Turn around.
No! Nice. You better hope this thing still runs or we're quadruple fucked.
I'm not gonna let you ruin your life for my screw-up!
If I let you go to prison, my life will be ruined! You think I'd be able to live with myself if I did?
If we actually go through with this, Our lives are gonna change forever.
I know.
You sure about this? Howard, you got the call, right?
What call?
A call from Esoteria Maximum Security Prison to confirm Bernard's arrival.
Sergeant Richards, EPD.
Richards, this is Roman. I need you to verify the arrival of a prisoner at Esoteria Maximum.
Oh, certainly, Mr. Drake. I'll just check the system. Name?
Brown. First name, Bernard.
I don't see anyone by that name in the system. But it could just be that I'm checking it too soon and he hasn't been registered yet. One second, Governor. Hey! Hey, did the prison receive a Bernard Brown recently? He's not in the system, but I might just be checking it too soon. No? Are you sure? Okay. I'm sorry, Governor, but no prisoner by that name has been received yet.
Something wrong, sir?
Those sons of bitches!
Sir?
Listen to me very carefully. I want you to assemble every officer you can spare within 10 minutes and set up blockades at every city exit. Be on the lookout for Bernard Brown, who may be accompanied by Edward Stryker, an officer assisting him in his escape. They're most likely in a police warthog and at least one of them is armed. Brown's armor is all tan and Stryker's is blue and probably sporting a badge. I want the retrieval to be a top priority, understand?
Yes, sir. Richard's out.
God damn it!
Is there anything you need me to do, Mr. Drake?
I wouldn't expect you to be able to close your groin plate without getting your dick caught, Howard. Why the fuck would I give you any orders? Either this is gonna blow up in our face, we're gonna get caught and face serious charges, or we're gonna be fugitives in hiding for the rest of our lives.
Don't remind me, like I said, if I let all that sink in, I'd probably go insane.
Feel lucky that you're driving then. When you're in this seat, your mind can't help but wander. Oh shit!
What?
Our ID chips! God damn it, they're gonna be able to see exactly where we are and head straight for us!
Ugh, relax. It's okay. I took my ID chip out of my suit already.
Oh! Oh, that's great! Thank God for that! You took your chip out, so no worries! Let's all go home and masturbate! What about mine? If they can track one of us, we're fucked!
Will you chill out? I smuggled a thingy from the department's armory. It's in the back seat. As long as you're within range, it blocks your ID chip signal.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Okay. So as long as I stay in the car for the rest of eternity, I'm good? Yeah, that's good.
It'll just be until we get to a safe spot where I can take the chip out of your suit myself. It's kind of a complex procedure. Not something I could really do right there in front of Roman and his army of officers.
Hold on a second. If you've taken out your ID chip, and I'm supposed to stay within range of this signal jammer, how the hell are we supposed to get through Canadian customs at the border? Do a little dance? These chips act as our passports.
I haven't quite figured that out yet.
Oh, great.
I'm I'm sorry, Governor Drake, but we've set up blockades at every exit, and after nearly 7 hours, have yet to find anyone exiting the city that goes by the name Bernard Brown or Edward Stryker fitting your description. It's possible that they fled the city before we even had a chance to assemble.
Okay. Contact the departments in all neighboring cities and have them set up blockades at their entrances to check for the same fugitives. Meanwhile, I want you and your team to branch out in whichever directions you think Brown and Stryker are likely headed, that don't contain any kind of security checkpoints or whatever else that might give away their location.
Understood, sir. Richard's out.
You shouldn't have played games with him. Now things have gotten out of hand. Let my men and I find Brown and Stryker.
That won't be necessary. I have the EPD and all neighboring departments hunting them down.
It would take 100 of your officers to amount to one of my men. Brown is beyond a mere oblivious annoyance now. He could be a genuine threat to your campaign. He needs to be dealt with appropriately. I'll take your silence as a green light.
Don't fail me.
I won't.
Can we stop? I gotta poo so bad.
Bernard, we're only about 40 miles away from the Canadian border. Just hold it in.
I have been holding it in.
I just don't think it's a good idea to stop while we're still in the U.S.
Come on, 5 minutes. We've been driving for 20 hours. Just give me 5 minutes before I shit my pants.
Well, we are low on gas. Looks like we're gonna have to stop anyway to refuel. Hold on.
Thank God.
Wait!
What?
You gotta stay within range of the thingamajig!
What the fuck? What?
The thing! The signal jammer! You have to stay close to it! Come back to the Warthog!
Oh, for Christ's sake! I have to poo! That's it. I'm going right here. Don't look, weirdo.
Oh, yeah. Alright, I'm gonna go pay for this.
What? Wait! You gotta keep a lookout for me!
I'll be back in a sec!
What the fuck? Dude, check it out. Is that guy taking a shit?
Oh, God. Keep going. Please keep going. For fuck's sake! Why don't you assholes take a picture?
Oh, yeah. Dude, get the camera.
What? Oh, don't actually.
You cheese faggot.
Sons of bitches.
Fully evacuated?
And humiliated. Let's go, Canada Ho. We gotta find the path of least resistance here.
What do you mean?
I mean, we gotta get in a lineup where the border guard's gonna go easy on us.
You mean like a chick?
No, you don't go for female border guards. They know people take advantage of their sensitivity, so they overcompensate and they're even worse than the guys. We gotta find a Canadian border guard. Canadians at least have a reputation of being friendly.
What about this border guard? Do you think he's Canadian? Hey there!
Your identification chip is now being scanned. Hold still.
Do you need any photo ID?
I'm the one asking the questions here. What's your purpose for leaving the U.S.?
Well,
business or pleasure?
Pleasure, I guess.
You guess? What the hell do you mean, you guess?
Well, I'm meeting up with friends that I know through work, so I'm not sure if that would be regarded as business or pleasure.
Why are you so nervous, sir?
I'm not, I'm just...
Step out of the car, please, sir.
What? What did I do?
This is Kenneth from the Department of Homeland Security, requesting backup due to non-compliance from a possible member of Al-Qaeda. Bring the drug-sniffing dogs.
What?
No, he's American.
Reverse.
There, pull into this one over here.
How do you know he's Canadian?
You kidding me? You just have to look at his armor. Alright, let me do most of the talking. Play it cool. Hey, officer.
Hello, sir.
I'm gonna activate the ID chip scanner. Please remain calm and motionless. This will only take a moment.
Hey, Eddie, how about that Canucks game the other night? Huh?
Oh, you watched it too, eh? 3-0, how about that?
I know, man. I really hope our boys bring home the cup this year.
Amen to that. So I take it you two are Canadian citizens?
No.
Ow!
We certainly are. Cool. But may I ask why your armor is off-color?
Oh, we just got back from a costume party. We went as Americans, didn't we, Eddie?
Yeah. How about that Stephen Harper? Eh? He's a character, isn't he?
Before I let you through, I just need you to declare the quantity of Canadian bacon in your vehicle. The limit is 50 pounds.
Oh, we have nothing to declare, officer. We have no Canadian bacon.
No, I'm afraid you don't understand, sir. 50 pounds of Canadian bacon in your vehicle is the minimum requirement for entry into the country.
You're kidding, right?
Yeah, I'm just messing with you guys. I'm sorry, I couldn't resist. It's actually 25 pounds.
I cannot believe we had to actually backtrack and buy 25 pounds of Canadian bacon just so we could get through. What kind of fucked up law is that?
Well, at least we still managed not to get our chip scanned. You know, you should probably adjust the temperature your suit regulates your body at. It's gonna be chilly in Canada.
Dude, that's a stereotype. It's not actually always cold and snowing in Canada. Jesus Christ.
Give me good news, Sergeant.
I'm sorry, Governor. Blockades have been set up at the entrances of every city surrounding Esoteria, and they've all yet to encounter the fugitives fitting your description.
These are your men?
Yes.
What a joke.
It would be wise not to talk to or look at my men in a disrespectful manner.
Or what?
You'd be dead had I not stopped them just now.
Gentlemen, forgive me.
If I overheard correctly, the police blockade stationed at the entrances to Esoteria and all its neighboring cities have yet to come into contact with Brown and Stryker, yes?
Right. It doesn't make sense. They should have caught them by now, I have no idea. Hey, where are you going?
The only other place that they could be heading.
Well, I don't know about you, but I could sure go for some hot food, a warm shower, and a comfy bed. I say we make a beeline for the nearest motel.
We gotta take your ID chip out before we do anything.
Alright, let's do that now. Pull over here.
Turn around. Okay, now bend over.
What?
I'm just kidding. But the chip is in the back of your suit, so just crouch down to make it easier for me. I hope Max and Howard are doing okay.
Yeah. Hey, can I ask you something?
Sure.
When we were all, at that club that one night, you didn't seem yourself.
Questions typically end with a question mark.
What was wrong with you that night?
Clubbing just isn't my scene.
Well, yeah, it isn't mine either, but to me it seemed like something was really bothering you.
It's out. Let's go find that motel.
Good evening, sirs.
Hey, we'd like a room for the night, if that's cool.
Certainly, we take cash, syrup, or maple leaves.
What?
But only Aunt Jemima syrup, and if you're paying by maple leaves, they have to be whole and not crumpled up.
Jeez. I guess here, money really does grow on trees, huh?
Yes.
Well, we'd like to pay by cash, please.
Well, leaves are preferred. Don't mean to make a big deal about it.
Yeah,
but
just cash.
Yeah,
we haven't been able to get our hands on any syrup.
Are the more widely
we just got
currencies here, and
yeah,
they are in Canada.
All
so,
we have is cash.
You know,
we don't have any of that other stuff.
You know what? This place isn't for us. We're sorry to have bothered you. Let's go, Eddie.
No, wait. I'm sorry. Cash will be fine. Yeah, it's fine.
Are you sure? I mean, we don't want to be a nuisance, but
no,
cash
not
is
at
all.
All
we have.
No, it's fine. I understand.
All right, cool. So, how much for the two of us for one night?
$728,592.46. Oh, man. Did you see the look on the guy's face when we took his picture?
Actually, no. We were kind of far away.
Yeah, neither did I.
Excuse me, gentlemen.
Yeah?
Would you guys be willing to help me out? I'm looking for a couple of guys that most likely passed through here on their way to Canada.
Yeah, I think Luke and Obi-Wan went back the way you came, Darth.
Yeah, very funny, guys, but this is a serious matter. The men I'm looking for are fugitives. They're traveling in a warthog. They're in brown and blue armor, and the guy in blue has a police badge. Have you seen them?
Dude, I think he's talking about that guy we photographed taking a shit. You think we should tell him?
No, I don't think we should. I don't like the look of these guys.
I'm sorry, but we haven't seen anybody.
Yeah.
You sure about that?
Yeah.
I'd advise you to answer that question carefully.
We haven't seen anybody.
I think you have. I was an interrogator for the U.S. military for 9 years. Forgive my ability to smell bullshit a mile away.
You're pathetic. I bet you wouldn't be acting the tough guy if your boyfriend here wasn't pointing a loaded gun at us.
Go and search their car. See what you can find. Alright, this is your chance to escape. I'm gonna give you the first punch. If you think you can take me, go for it. Come on. Hit me! Okay, now that that's over with, tell me what I want to know or your friend dies. There goes one kneecap.
Damn it!
Stop wasting my time. Tell me when and where you saw the two men and which direction they were headed.
Okay. We saw them at a gas station about 40 miles south of the border, and they headed north. They're probably on their way to Canada, but we're not sure. We didn't even talk to them.
Thank you. Fortunately, there's a lot of gang activity in this area. No one will make a fuss when they find you two little shits face down in the water. There's probably more deaths here simply being pinned on gang warfare than there actually are gang warfare-related deaths. That in the car? Are there any pictures on it? Drown the kid.
We've been walking forever, man. I'm so thirsty. Wait, is there water and snow?
The sun's going down. We gotta find a warm place to crash or we'll be frozen solid by tomorrow morning. Maybe we could... No, never mind.
What?
Nothing, it was a stupid idea.
What is it?
I was thinking we could build an igloo or something. I don't know.
What the hell is that?
You've never heard of an igloo?
No.
It's like a little snow house thing. A house made out of snow.
Snow houses? What the hell is up with these Canadians, man? Igloos, leaves, and syrup for currency. Rick Mercer on every fucking TV channel.
I know, but you got any better ideas?
Yeah, actually. Pull out your gun for a sec.
Okay.
Okay, now point it at my head. You do me first, then I'll do you.
We're not killing ourselves.
Alright, let's freeze to death then. Because making a snow house sounds like the stupidest idea ever.
The stupidest idea ever would be standing here with our thumbs up our asses and freezing overnight. Look, this is a real thing people do in, like, snowy environments.
What, people actually build a door, a hallway, a couple bedrooms?
We're not building some condo in Tuscany, jerk-off. It's a simple half-sphere.
So, what, we just roll a giant snowball and hollow it out or something?
A half-sphere, not a hamster ball. You pack together like snow bricks, and then you put them in a circle, and then stack more bricks upwards and inwards until the top is closed. Let's make some bricks.
Oh my god. This sucks, it's all powdery.
Yeah, really. We might as well be working with sand. God damn it!
Hey, Bernard. Check that out over there.
Is that a cave?
Looks like it. To hell with this snowhouse crap.
Stay on your toes. With our luck, there's probably a fucking grizzly bear in here.
Stop right there! Eddie? Bernard?
Max?
So, after you guys left the club that night, I got talking to this guy, and for some reason I ended up in his apartment here the next morning, hungover as fuck. He kicked me out after I told him I didn't remember anything from the night before, and since then I roamed the Canadian landscape until I came across this fine gentleman.
Are you two Americans as well?
Yeah. Yeah.
The two of us have just been chilling in this cave since then. So there you go. That's my story. Hope you enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it.
Okay, your turn. What the hell are you guys doing here? I bet your story isn't as awesome as mine.
No.
Actually, we're fugitives.
What?
Fugitives? Yeah. Bernard here only went and got himself arrested.
Stop talking.
So it's just Bernard here that's a fugitive. Well, at first, until I was supposed to escort him to prison, but I decided to help him escape instead, so now we both are.
You're still talking.
What the hell did you do, Bernard?
God damn it, Eddie, you shouldn't have said anything.
They'd have found out eventually.
I was the one that took down the bomb maker a few weeks ago.
That guy was off limits.
And that's why I'm a fugitive, for stopping a ruthless killer from taking any more lives.
Well, it's no big deal.
It isn't?
Nope. As soon as we find a way back to the States, we'll get you two behind bars in no time. It's cool.
What?
No, it's not cool.
You'd be willing to throw us in jail?
Hey, you made the decision to throw your career onto the fire when you helped this moron escape. You expect me to become your accomplices and throw mine on as well?
Come on, Eddie, let's go.
Where do you think you're going?
We obviously don't see eye to eye here. We're going our separate ways.
You're not going anywhere.
Yeah, watch us.
I'll watch you sit your ass back down.
You don't scare me, you big G.I. Joe wannabe.
Alright guys, let's just chill for a second here. Obviously, you all need a comfy place to work things out amongst yourselves. Luckily, I have just the place.
Huh?
I own a rather large hotel just a few miles east of here.
Then what the hell have we been sitting in this cave for?
Any chance we could stay in one of your hotel rooms for a little while? Between Eddie and I think we have enough cash to stay for about 2 days.
Oh, no, nonsense. You guys can stay for as long as you like, free of charge. I haven't had guests for the longest time. Sweet!
Thanks.
Count me out.
Aw, Max, don't go. We've obviously got a lot of stuff to work through. Come on.
We have nothing to work through. If I ignore my obligations and people see me hanging out with you two, my life is fucked as well. And it'll be the three of us on the run. We never found each other.
Max!
The people we all work for are not good people, Max. We're not the bad guys here. Wow, this place is gorgeous.
Yeah, this place really is something, Dudley.
Oh, well, thanks, guys.
Wow.
All right, I'll be at reception if you guys need me. Enjoy your stay.
Thanks. Wonder what's on TV.
We now return to Rick Mercer, the movie, starring Rick Mercer, written and directed by Rick Mercer. I'm Rick Mercer. We now return to Just for Laughs, Gags, with the pranksters and the victims played by Rick Mercer. I, Rick Mercer, just played a hilarious prank on you. Wow, Rick Mercer, you sure fooled me, Rick Mercer.
I hate Canadian TV.
It's fucking cold outside. That's some heavy construction outside our room just there, you see that?
This is so lame. They have a Canadian remake of that old show Friends called Buddies, and all the buddies are Rick Mercer.
Rick? Rick? I'm home from work. Oh, hey, Rick. About time, Rick. Where have you been? Who's that? Aw, man, not Rick again. Aw, not you, Rick. Mr. Mercer. Figures I'd find you here.
This sucks.
Yeah.
Where's Bernard, anyway?
He had enough of seeing Rick Mercer on TV and went to the lobby to see if there's at least one other channel. Said if he saw or heard him one more time, he'd jump off the balcony. Ah, Officer Brown, how can I help you, buddy?
Hey, man, look, I don't mean to be a pain in the ass, but do you guys get any channels other than just that one?
You know what? There actually is another channel that should be available now.
Really? Can I get it in our room?
Certainly. As a matter of fact, it's on the television behind you right now.
We now return to Cool Cops on Box.
You gotta be shitting me.
The film crew said this would draw some attention to my hotel, give it some notoriety. Sorry. Hey, this show looks kinda cool. Reality cop show.
This guy on camera walks pretty funny. Looks like he has a stick up his ass.
Yeah, or like he's constipated or something. And doesn't it seem to you like he's limping, kind of? He has sort of a limp.
Yeah, he could be drunk. Probably something mentally wrong with him or something. Poor guy.
Yeah. I wonder if he can speak properly, or if he can even eat properly.
Maybe he has a guy feeding him and, like, cleaning his house. You can hire people to do that kind of shit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh.
Hey.
Hey. So, what the hell's this?
Dudley hired a film crew to cover our stay to give his hotel some notoriety. Damn it, there's always some little price to pay for everything, isn't there? No exceptions. Nothing's just free, no. I'm going for a nap.
I think I'm gonna head down to the vending machine on the lower floor. Eddie, you wanna come?
Yeah, sure.
Dude, what the shit?
Sorry. It's just that your room seems to be the only one with a free outlet. Do you mind if I charge my spare batteries for the camera in here?
Do you mind if you fuck off?
What?
Nothing, fine, whatever.
I, thought I heard you say something there for a second.
Something rude.
Bernard did the right thing. It's the system. Bernard's a victim of a broken system.
It's our only system. It's the best alternative we've come up with to orderless chaos. Bernard didn't play by the rules, and he's suffering the consequences.
Rules? This isn't a board game. If it is, life's a bad board game. One with broken rules that just isn't fun and you would refuse to play.
I've frozen my balls outside in Canada enough, okay? I came here because it was warm. Because that's what I deserve after years of dedication. But by doing so, I'm affiliating myself with Bernard. And just because he was a little rebellious prick and did something he shouldn't have, I've got to get dragged into the quicksand too. Lose my job, all my hard work.
Bernard?
We gotta talk, guys. Dude, this is great. Can you go away?
Hey, you can shut me out, but if you don't give me anything, no one likes or watches the show, Mr. Punter gets no publicity, and you get no hotel suite. You're turning yourself in?
Yeah. Here's what we're gonna do. We'll head back to the States. Max, we'll say that I suspected that I was gonna get arrested and I kidnapped you for leverage or something. Eddie, we'll say that on your way to escorting me to prison, I overpowered you and I managed to get a hold of your gun and make you drive Max and I to Canada. We'll say that I slipped on some ice or something and you managed to get your gun back, Eddie. The two of you will take me to prison and I'll pretend to resist, but plead guilty.
What about you? You didn't do anything wrong.
Being arrested for bending some bad rules is a crime in itself, but trying to avoid prison by ruining two other law-abiding people's lives is even worse.
And who are they?
You. And Max.
Oh. Right.
I gotta do my time. No way around it. I'm really sorry for this fucking wild goose chase, guys. It's over now.
I like how you overpower both Eddie and me in your story, but we only gain the upper hand because you fell on your ass on some fucking ice.
What?
Come on, you think you can take both of us and hold us hostage for this long, were you Steven Seagal? Hell, I could take you myself, no problem.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Alright, well, I only came up with all that in like 4 minutes, okay? We can come up with something better. Also, notice that I said we. If we left it up to you, it would probably be that you got me in a fucking headlock and dragged me from Canada all the way to the States with your bare hands, right?
Are you sure this is what you want to do?
Yeah. Now this is good television. Can you guys actually pause there for a second? I gotta go down to my car and get a new tape.
Oh.
find Bernard's room number.
Whoa, 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 please. Don't do this. You can't. Don't hurt me.
You guys expecting anyone?
Not me.
No.
Huh. It's probably the camera guy. I thought he had a room key, though. Who is it?
Don't open it.
Oh, shit.
Was nothing. Hey!
Bernard, Max, we can get to the lower floor from the balcony. Move it!
Nicer than ours.
Lock the door behind me. Oh shit, get back! You're coming down the stairs! Get back!
Oh shit, there's no way out.
The elevator. Come on!
Come on! Nice asshole!
Eddie! Oh.
I can't believe this is it. This is how it ends. Executed in front of Roman.
I could have executed you days ago. If I were you, I'd be savoring my last few breaths. Wait there. Don't try running.
I cannot believe this. I gave everything to this job, and now my own government's ready to snuff me.
Sorry, guys.
Better be. This really sucks.
Governor Drake, it's Mason Clark. I have him here at the front gates. Open up. Governor Drake, open the front gates. Governor Drake.
I'll be waiting for you in hell.
Whoa.
What's the meaning of this?
Vengeance.
He's got the entire department wired with explosives, disguised it as construction work.
I've been waiting for him.
You.
The weird guy's brother?
Thanks for letting us all know. We had no idea.
You recorded my voice and had me arrested.
Oh my god, did I? My sincere apologies, but I was hoping we'd brush a little on the hiccup on your end. Sibling murder? Does that ring a bell?
I'm sorry.
You will be.
Look, I wasn't the only one indirectly responsible. This entire department is, except I was the only one that actually didn't want him to die.
Hence why this entire department will burn to the ground.
Where are all the police?
He slaughtered everybody.
This guy took down an entire police department? What is this guy, Commando? Nonetheless, you were significantly involved in his death. You took him from me. There was nothing I could do. You made me feel powerless. You will now experience the same.
Don't do this.
Can you bring him back?
No.
Very well. May God have mercy on your soul.
Wait, no!
Eddie? Max? Max? Where's Eddie?
What? How am I? I think I'm all right, thanks.
I don't see him anywhere. Eddie!
Stay for a long time, bro. Look what you did, bro. You successfully destroyed all order in Esoteria.
I assume you're using the term order very loosely.
A bullet in the abdomen and still making wisecracks. You seem to forget that by being an officer, you're upholding the very regime you have such a problem with.
The best position available to keep real jerk-offs like you at bay.
Oh, is that what this is? Is this you keeping me at bay, bro? Are you gonna kick my ass, bro? Is that it? When are you gonna realize just how pathetic you are? No one can save you now. Any last words?
Conveniently, all evidence incriminating us has been destroyed. Mason is dead. Roman's dead. Every city law enforcement official in Esoteria is gone. Well, except for us three. And one more, who thankfully just didn't feel like coming to work that fateful day.
I felt sick.
Bullshit. You were probably playing some video game as usual.
Oh, speaking of which, I finally got past that block puzzle in RE4 and beat it.
Did you finish in record time?
14 hours, 6 minutes.
Well, that's gotta be a record.
Shouldn't we be working?
There hasn't been a single broadcast all day.
Because we're the only cops in the whole city. Of course there aren't.
We've got a job to do, gentlemen.
About a million bullets worth.
I'll sit on my ass as usual. Go get 'em, boys.
Come on, Bernard. The city isn't gonna clean itself.
What a ridiculous fucking plot.